Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to an episode of Let's Play Town of Salem. This is the game I recently picked up. It has already started at this point. I pressed the record button a little bit late, but it is a good game. And I wanted, or I thought this would be a good game to do my first video on. I have a fairly standard role with being the godfather of the mafia. First of all, let me break down the game to you. You always have 15 players in a session. One session or one game takes about 15 or 20 minutes, and you have townspeople, which are the green ones on the roll list you can see, and the red ones are the mafia. I'm the leader of the mafia as the godfather. There's also a serial killer, a jester, and an executioner, which are roles which don't belong to one of the big factions being Mafia and Town. So every night the town is trying to kill somebody. And on the daytime the town is trying to hang us, the mafia, and they are also trying to hang the serial killer. The serial killer is also killing every night like we the mafia do, but the serial killer is independent from us, and at some point of the game we want to get rid of the serial killer and the serial killer wants to get rid of us. So you can't win with both faction standing. The executioner and the jester are neutral roles. The executioner wants to have somebody killed, and the jester wants to be killed, but I won't cover this for now. It's a little bit sad that I had to break down my game while the game was already running. Because last day I was actually voting against my fellow mafia people. I'm not sure if I realized what I was doing. I think I kinda was in the end. But as a godfather, I really don't want to help my other mafia people in the public. It's a way I'm playing mafia, especially godfather, that I would recommend to anybody. You often see the mistake that the mafia is sticking together in the daily chat, so if there's one mafia killed, you are pretty sure which the others are. To break down more details of the game, everyone has a different role, or maybe some roles are maybe taken two times or three times in the same game. But you will have certain abilities as a town. You will have maybe some investigation abilities, like the sheriff, who can just see if somebody is mafia or serial killer, or if somebody is not suspicious. The investigator will get different info, but it has kind of the same quality. He will know that you are one of two or three different roles. So that's all. And you will also have a jailer who can jail people at night, etc. So the town has different measures of bringing us down. So I tried to kill Pasha, and Pasha was immune. That can also happen. At this point, for me, this means he is a serial killer or an executioner. These are the only roles which are immune. The third role that is immune is myself. And since we didn't attack myself, it has to be one of the other two roles. If you want to pick up the game, at least for your second game, I would recommend you to read shortly the list of all the roles that are in a classic game. The classic game is also the game version that I would recommend you to play in your first few sessions, because it's a good way to pick the game up. But I will get more detailed on the different game modes in the another video, not on the this one, the first one. Okay, there's different blaming going on in the chat. I'm also blaming some stuff. I want to be talkative as a godfather, to not be suspicious, because people that don't talk in chat usually have something to hide. And somehow we got DSK voted. And that's okay, he says the sheriff. And as a mob, I can just see that he's not one of us, so it's good if we get him killed for me. If he's a serial killer, it's good. If he's another town, that's also good. If he's a sheriff, that's especially good, because the sheriff just could, with a lucky knight, he can just see that I'm the godfather and have me killed. And I think it was the sheriff that we just hung. Yep. That's really good for us. Okay, so they are on to Willow. Just because the sheriff who died said it in his will. And Willow should already know that I won't help her one bit. Because I'm the fucking GF. And I'm sorry, language sometimes get carried away in this game. The game doesn't have the best community, so you should have some skin if you're playing this game on a social level, because people just tend to go nuts in this game. They're sometimes just totally confused, and I think that's what get the people so far to the edge in this game sometimes. Anyways, we have killed a medium. I'm not sure why didn't I tried to kill John Smith. He was healed by a doctor. So this is bad. And somebody is blaming me to be godfather. That's what thing that you really don't want to see in chat. And now Willow is defending me, and that's a total no-go. If you are already pretty much revealed as a mob, you don't wanna defend your GF in the global chat, because when you killed them and you defended him, it's pretty obvious that he is in fact the Godfather. There are many, many things that you have to pay attention to in chat, but don't worry if you pick up the game, there are many people who don't play the game good, so even if you're a little bit shy on, I don't know, lying and stuff and deceiving people, which you definitely have to do in this game, I think you will get the hang of it pretty easily after a few games. It's not a really pro community. I think there are also many young people, let's say that. Maybe not kids, but very young people who are a little bit impatient and just will kill anybody. Yeah, and as you just saw, I voted guilty for my own mafia fellow. But I just don't want other people to know. If I've voted innocent, they would know for sure that I'm the Godfather. And information is the key of the game. I don't want to give it to them. So I'm not really sure if I know who the doctor is. I really want to know who the doctor is. And you often have to read the chat log, I think, because you will often miss key moments in chat that will reveal much. I'm going again for John Smith. I think that's just so stupid that it might actually work. No, it didn't. It didn't work. But I'm actually a little lucky that the serial killer is still living. And even though we killed nobody last night, it's pretty obvious that Nice is the serial killer. There were many people pointing to him as a serial killer. And it's good for me that the town has another objective other than finding the Godfather. So I'm voting to kill the serial killer at this point. For some reason I claimed doctor, and there are three other people claiming doctor, Nice is one of them. But at least his alibi is really weak at this point. And I could have wanted the serial killer to live, because the serial killer cannot kill me at night. So it might be helpful. But if I would have voted innocent on the serial killer, it would have been pretty obvious that I'm a bad guy. So let's see, I should have picked up that Slevin should be the doctor. I think John Smith claimed at some point Slevin is the doctor. And since I'm sure John Smith was Tom, I'm pretty sure this is correct. And I really have to kill the doctor at this point. Because he's keeping blocking my attacks, and he can heal himself only one time. When the dog is healing somebody, it means he is defending them for the night. The target gets unkillable for mafia or serial killers. I may be a little bit sorry for throwing you guys right into the game. You might be a little confused about what's going on at all right now. But I will make a follow-up video, I think, where I will just explain the interface of the game, etc. Okay, I'm blaming Pasha and Select Name at this point, because I'm sure somebody of them is Jester. And the Jester still wants to get killed, and even though they know I'm the Godfather, for sure, right now, I am just trying to bet on the point that the Jester wants to die. That's why I accused both Pasha and Select Name before yeah, and I just said it to them that I offered to kill them. And the Jester should know that even if he is letting me live, that it's unlikely that he will get hung. But way, I got an achievement because the Jester decided to vote me innocent. And I don't know why, but the executioner, which is Pasha, is totally raging about this. I don't know why. I know sometimes executioners tend to want to help the town win, but I don't know why he has to write everything in capital letters. Yeah, and again the language, of course. And I thought for the next day I would write something like vote Select Name to get him killed, but I realized if I now kill the last town and only two neutral trolls are surviving, I will have won the game. So I'm just typing GG. One of the annoying things in the game is the mechanic of the chatbox. Often you will want to write stuff, but you can't, so if you enter it, it will just not pop up and be deleted. That's sometimes annoying, especially if you write something long. So right now I wrote GG and then GG, sorry for not executing you. Select Name, who's the Jester. And I didn't write it again, just because I have to wait for all the events to happen. But I'm positive they will be updating many things. The game is still in some kind of beta, I think. It's free to play. I will post the link in the description. I hope you picked it up. I hope you enjoyed this gameplay so far. I will put some more on and some more explanations, so you won't be lost if you will try to pick it up. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you next time. Goodbye.